So you see, I didn't always want to be a country singer. I actually told Mom, I came home and said, Mom, I want to be a rock star. And she said, bull crap, you're going to be a rock star. She said, rock stars don't go to church, Corey. And she goes, you're either going to sing country or you're going to sing gospel. And so I was like, man, I'll go ahead and sing country. I was all kind of ticked off. And then I started looking, you know, Keith Urban, he just got out of rehab not too long ago. John Michael Montgomery was in rehab. Joe Nichols, are like, they're more badass than rock stars are. And then I heard a Waylon Jennings song, and I lost it from there. So I blame it on Waylon, y'all.
To an 94 train, back no free. Just on my daddy, good looks on my mama. But as long as Rosa in my soul, you know I'm blaming it all.
Associates again, they gave us a very hefty check to come on up here, so I appreciate the out of it. Also, DJ Freese, I know you're out there somewhere. I also want to thank you for the life lessons you taught me. See, I used to date DJ's daughter when I was in high school, and you guys remember when the Fifth Avenue Bridge in Decor, you could actually jump it with your truck? Remember when you could do that? Well, he saw me one time with his daughter in my truck. And I got home that night dropping her off, and he goes, Corey, come here, come here. He goes, listen, man, you can kill yourself on your own time, but if you ever do a dumb stunt like that with my daughter in a truck again, I'll kill you on my time. So if I ever have a daughter, I know exactly how to scare the other little piss out of her boyfriend. So thank you, DJ, for the life lessons.